There is excitement from a customer perspective in terms of what can be done, and there is excitement from a business perspective in terms of, hey, this is the reason why you got to move to the cloud. You know, you have all your data in the cloud, the AI can parse it, can understand it, can help you decode it, can help you break silos, and can make the user experience ultimately better.
Welcome to the Microsoft Cloud Executive Enablement Series, where we speak with Microsoft Cloud senior leaders and experts about the latest trends in technologies we're seeing in the market. The goal of this series is to share with you and your teams our perspective on the business value driven by the Microsoft Cloud for our mutual customers and the opportunities for our partners to grow their business with Microsoft.
Hello, and thank you for joining us. My name is Justin Slade, the Global Business Strategy Lead for Partner Enablement here at Microsoft. And I lead a team of partner enablement specialists who help partners build technical capacity and capability for the Microsoft Cloud. On today's episode, we'll delve into generative AI, powered by tools like Copilot, and how it is opening up new possibilities in the world of Dynamics and Power Platform by enabling organizations to create intelligent apps, generate code, and design workflows more efficiently than ever before. I'm excited to have Gio Mezgec, Modern Work and Business Applications Field Partner Marketing Vice President at Microsoft, as our guest speaker. Gio, it's fantastic to see you again, and I'm really looking forward to hearing you talk about Dynamics 365 and Power Platform product innovation today.
No, thank you for having me. I'm really excited to talk about the business application business at Microsoft today with you.
Excellent. Talk to me a little bit about business.
Well, you know, I'm new to this business. I've been at Microsoft for a long time. I joined the business application team about 6 months ago. I must say, it's one of the best secrets at Microsoft. We've been in this space for over 25 years, so we have long roots. Most of our Fortune 500 customers have one of our business application one way or the other, so we have a great customer base. But we're still seeing tremendous growth. We have seen growth of 30%. On the Dynamics 365 business, and the Power Apps business is also growing really, really fast.
Tremendous growth. So what's your highlight?
Dynamics 365 growing 30% year over year. That's revenue. And for Power Platform, passing 33 million monthly active users. So we're seeing growth from a revenue perspective, as well as just continued growth of users, continue to use it every day, and it's growing fast. So no matter the past, we're seeing tremendous opportunity with our customers to really do incredible things moving forward. So that's why I say the best secret of Microsoft. No one really knows it or understands it very well, but it's really incredible.
Sounds like the best secret in the ecosystem. What is it about the product that the partners are really reacting to? Is it the product innovation? Is it the solutions that the product is providing?
Yeah, I think there's a couple of things. Number one, the customer intimacy required in the business application space is really big. You know, most of the stuff we do at Microsoft, we talk to CIOs, it's about infrastructure, it's about IT. With business applications, you have to go deep into the business processes, understand the challenges that customers are having from a business perspective. So the relationship with the customers really is a bit different than what we have traditionally done. And the other thing is that the product that we have is really incredible. You know, the innovation that we have brought to move a bunch of legacy applications on-prem to the cloud has really transformed our business. That's where we're seeing a lot of excitement from our customers. Customers are responding to what we're delivering there.
You've talked about customers. I know you're new in the role, and if you're anything like me, you like to get out into the field and meet our customers and meet our partners as well. Talk to me a little bit about the partner meetings and what the partners are saying to you about the product.
You know, there are two classes of partners that I've met so far. The first one are the partners that have been in this business for a long time. They're truly the expert. They kind of grew up in this business, and they're the ones that really help us and guide us through in terms of what we should do next, what's the competition doing, what our customers wanting. So those are, you know, really an incredible group of people, lots of passion, they all know one another, you know, and they've been in this business for 30 years. They're saying, hey, it's fantastic innovation in terms of moving to the cloud, what we're doing, how we can compete with the rest of the market in different ways now than what we have traditionally done. Then there is the second cluster of partners, the ones that They know the Microsoft ecosystem, but I haven't really gone deep on business application and on Dynamics specifically. There's interest in those, but I think we could do so much more in terms of working with them and with the first partner community that has been with us for a long time to find new opportunities and working together in a way that brings new innovation to customers and transforming really business processes and make them more flexible, more dynamic. You know, if you talk to customers, there's still a lot of issues in terms of user interface being not very simple, silos of data and multiple systems glom together. You know, this stuff is sometimes complex, and we can make it all so much simpler using an infrastructure that's cloud-based, that's modern, that can bring all this to customers in a different way. So lots of opportunity, lots of excitement, but it's also a difficult space, very entrenched competition. You know, I don't need to tell you who our competitors are. But it's a tough space, and we got to make sure that we work together to really pass the scrutiny of our customers to deliver real innovation together.
Well, talking about the value prop and innovation, I'm sure you've heard this thing called Dynamics 365 Copilot. Tell me a little bit about the buzz that's around this innovation.
Yeah, I'm really excited about it. Number one, it can really transform the user experience. You know, if you're in marketing, if you're in finance, if you're in sales, having an application that understands what you do, it can help you through the means of the AI. It can really transform your experience. And so from a user perspective, from a customer perspective, it's really incredible technology. The other thing from a business perspective is that it's stuff that you cannot have on-prem. It's only cloud-based. And so that further accelerate the transformation of moving customers from their legacy applications to the cloud on a new modern infrastructure. So there is excitement from a customer perspective in terms of what can be done, and there is excitement from a business perspective in terms of, hey, this is the reason why you got to move to the cloud. You know, you have all your data in the cloud, the AI can parse it, can understand it, can help you decode it, can help you break silos, and can make the user experience ultimately better. So if you are the marketing person or in finance or in operations, you know, you just can have a much better sense and insight from the business and how you can act on it with precision.
Well, let's do a click down on that a little bit. How do partners monetize Dynamics 365 Copilot? Like, how does it help with the revenue streams?
So we need to differentiate here between the work that we have done on Dynamics 365 and the work that we have done on Power Platform. Let's talk about the first one, Dynamics 365. We have made AI part of our products. So you have Dynamics 365, you will get to use our AI functionality. As a matter of fact, we launched Dynamics 365 in AI about 6 months ago. I think we have over 72,000 organizations currently using it. So lots of enthusiasm there from that perspective. So there it's infused.
Yep.
And so the way it helps the business of the partners and our business is basically saying, use Dynamics 365. You can take advantage of cloud-based services that are AI enabled that can make your life better, period. Mm-hmm. There is no need of additional things or do, you know, more integration. It's all integrated in. On Power Platform, it's actually on top. And so you can use Power Platform to automate processes. That the more I found out about it, the more I realized with Power Platform, you can surround the system of record, but you can also automate new processes in customers. You can understand where customers have inefficiencies. Where do they use papers? Where do they get calls from customers that are never recorded? And use Power Platform to automate them independently of Dynamics 365. Their AI is on top, so it's an additional business for us. It's just a slightly different configuration, but the fact of what you can do with AI in terms of like, hey, just build me an app that does this, this, and this, and automatically does it, it creates so much simplicity that our partners are loving, and they can replicate with their own customers, and customers are responding really positively to it.
If I'm hearing you right, we're giving partners the agility and the creativity to create their own apps and then monetize those apps themselves on Power Platform.
Absolutely. With that, the opportunity is to basically go into a customer and say, I want to look at where we can make you more efficient. Where do you have inefficient processes? And then go, or applications that are legacy that you have not touched for a long time, that they cost because, you know, you got to keep them up to date, you got to manage them. We can help them make it better and move them to Power Platform so that they're modern, they have a great UI, they're integrated with the rest of the Microsoft infrastructure, and they can be managed effectively. And through that, build a practice that really monetize that and build a business around it.
Oh, that's just fantastic to hear that our partners and customers are really embracing Copilot. Continuing on the theme of innovation, Talk to me a little bit about the announcement of new solutions and unification of Dynamics 365 marketing and customer insights. It sounds super intriguing.
Yeah, we wanted to simplify the product lineup and make sure that we could give our customers a unified view of their own customer base. And so the product that we have integrated together really are there to provide a 360 of what, you know, an organization can see of how they interact with their customers, what they do with it, so they can be better at it. So from that perspective, I think we're becoming a lot better. And really, if you look at the competition in the space, you wouldn't think that we are as good as we are product-wise. So I strongly suggest all partners to take a look at it and see the incredible innovation that we brought forward and what we can do together with our partners and partner solutions to really help customers enable better interaction with their customers and better experiences with their customers. It's not only for marketing, but also in the services organizations. We are innovating and continue to bring forward new innovation to make support teams, anybody that interacts with customers from a perspective of helping customers do something better in an easy way. We're adopting technology like omnichannel so that services personnel can work, and communicate with customers across multiple modalities, by phone, by chat, still having a complete management console of how they work with customers. That's what it's all about, bringing all this data together to make sure that people can act on it, get right insights, and really have a better experience with their own customers.
The breadth of innovation here, Giovanni, is huge. I'm so impressed with what your team is doing.
It's an incredible portfolio. It's really deep and broad. And that's probably the reason why connecting to how we started. It's a best secret at Microsoft because not too many people spend the time to actually take, to go deep and really learn. But there are so many things that we can do and so many leverage points in terms of how can you build something that includes Dynamics 365 on Azure, that extends it, that makes application development with Power Application even better. So there are tons of opportunities that we can take, but it does require an effort. It does require the effort of partners to say, I want to go deep. I want to understand the opportunity and what I can make of it for my own business.
Well, I'd love to see it here longer and learn more from you. But I want to ask you that, to help drive adoption and the building on our technology, our partners are also asking about skilling, and they need skilling as well. Talk to me a little bit about what you're hearing about skilling and enablement.
Yeah, we have invested in a whole array and portfolio of tools to help on that regard, because it's something that it's very important to us and to our partners, and ultimately we want to make sure that they deliver great services to customers. So the quality of the skilling is super important. So from one-on-one training in terms of like, hey, this is the beginning of your journey, to deep demos and training and really all-hands support to really make the stuff happen on real code and real solutions. I think we have a very good portfolio that partners and anybody really can go deep on. And I think together with your team, we've done incredible things to really look at, okay, if you are a technical support person, this is your curriculum. If you are more in sales, these are the things that you got to learn and be able to recognize in terms of the challenges that you can have with customers. I think we have the full portfolio for people to take advantage of and for partners to really learn from.
Yeah, I think it's developing the skilling and the enablement around those particular role types that's really starting, learning journeys that's really starting to resonate with our partners and our customers now.
I hope that, partners can see that there is a tremendous opportunity here to do more, to partner with Microsoft, take our technology and extend it, partners with other partners to see what they are doing and see how they can extend it so that we can really help our customers transforming their business and taking advantage of the cloud and AI as the next revolution of where technology is going to change how the business is run.
Giovanni, it's been wonderful having you here today. I've learned so much. Thank you. The product innovation coming out of your team is tremendous. It's so good to hear our partners and customers are also embracing this product innovation. If we were to wrap up, and there are three things you'd like to leave with the audience, what would that be?
Yeah, the first one is, one of the best secrets at Microsoft, a tremendous depth of product and history. Two, there is a tremendous opportunity for partners to work with customers to really innovate their businesses. Three, AI and Copilot is going to disrupt the industry and create even more opportunities. So now it's the time.
Giovanni, it's been wonderful having you here today. Thank you. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And that wraps up today's episode. Don't forget that this episode is a part of a series featuring some of our most experienced and innovative global executives, packed full of great insights and examples of how to make the most out of working alongside Microsoft. If you haven't already, make sure to check out our other episodes. No matter your industry or area of focus, the Microsoft Global Partner Enablement Team is here to enable you and your teams to achieve more. If you want to hear a little more of this episode, we have a podcast which has some more of our discussion and some bonus content. If there's an area of cloud innovation you'd like to hear more about, please send us a note at salesenablement-gsi@microsoft.com so that we can create content that meets your enablement needs. Thank you for listening, thank you for engaging with us, and thank you for being a Microsoft partner. We'll see you on the next episode of the Microsoft Cloud Executive Enablement Series.